So he's already, he's swinging his tail. He don't like you.
So the day is here. The 2,000 gallon aquarium is now emptied. We only have a few inches of water in there. And it's time to move the fish so we can rescape the aquarium. I brought some help. We got Gary here. He's gonna help me move the fish. This is the plan. I'm gonna jump in the aquarium with various sizes of nets. I can't keep jumping in and out, so Gary is here so I can hand him the fish. He's going to take them and do his best to safely put them in the 375 gallon aquarium, which I showed you in the last video. We removed all the fish and most of the wood that we could so we could free up this tank because it has a large filtration system. It's about 500 gallons of water. This is going to allow us more time with the rays and animals in the tank so we could take our time properly scaping the tank. Slight problem. We're not just moving regular fish. We've got 4 Asian arowana. We've got 4 freshwater stingrays. And then of course there's a bicher in here as well. Now the freshwater stingrays are venomous, and I'm sure, Gary, you knew that?
Yes, yeah.
I'm gonna coach them as much as I can during the process, but we already ran through a few things beforehand. Let's just see how it goes. Okay, first thing I'm gonna wanna do is remove the wood. This is a place of injury for the fish in case they start panicking. I don't want them to be able to run into anything. I changed my mind. I don't want to do this. We're going to start by moving the bicher. We'll just use a basic net for this guy. They tend to be the most wiry, but if we move quickly, we should be able to get them. We just don't want to freak out the rays because they can, of course, attack. That was literally the first fish Gary has ever added to an aquarium.
Oh man. Oh man.
Alright. Now we're gonna get serious. For the rays, we're gonna use this rubber net. You guys might remember this from past videos. We're gonna guide them into the net. And this is good because they can't, or at least they'll have a difficult time getting their barbs stuck in the actual net. So this guy should lay flat as a pancake, Gary. All you're gonna wanna do is pick him up and go. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, don't worry about the water. Just go. There you go. Hook it out. Perfect, Gary. Perfect. Hey, he's pretty good at this. Have you moved stingrays before?
Just on vacation.
We're missing them, right? Oh, yeah, of course. Right by my feet. Okay. Another guy. Sorry, Bob. Come on in. Where's that little net? Just coax them in. You don't want to stress these guys out. I like to wait till they're in the middle of the net to pick them up so they don't flop. You never want a stingray or any family of the Alaskan branch to end up upside down. It could kill them. Believe it or not, these rays are going to be far easier to add to the aquariums than the Asian arowana. Give it a little jerk so he jumps over that. There you go. He'll go out. Maybe not.
Well, you don't want to live in the net.
There you go. He'll get out. There he goes. That's a girl, actually.
Got a little backwards.
He's going to freak out a little bit. The parameters in each aquarium are identical, so there's not much risk of shocking them. The arowana are being very nice, very well behaved. The thing I like about this net is when you scoop the fish up, the sand doesn't go with it. But rays can't really jump without a bit of a runoff. So once we pick them up, they're pretty much stationary. But they will use their tail almost like a scorpion and try to smack you. look way bigger in that tank.
Yeah.
He's already, he's swinging his tail. He don't like you. We'll go, just put it right upside down.
There you go. Very nice.
Now there's a little ray in there too that I'm kind of nervous about, but should be okay. For the Asian arowana, this is gonna be a little more difficult. I do have bags to move them, but on such a short distance, I feel better with using a large net. I'm gonna try to scoop them in this net. It is a shallow net, so we'll either have to do this or hold it with our hand. But these guys are jumpers. So regardless of what I do, they're gonna try to jump. So I'll have to snatch them up rather fast. Like that.
Oh my God.
He's gonna try to get out. So what they might do when you try to put them in the water and be careful is they'll try to jump out of the tank.
Yeah, that's what I was kind of trying to guide them over underneath the glass or the acrylic.
Gary is basically Jacques Cousteau now.
Mm-hmm. Fish specialist.
Fish. He's in the blue net. There you go. Look to be doing okay, maybe lose a couple scales. Again, the best way to move these guys is with a big plastic bag. We can do it much faster like this. And the plastic bags I have, I didn't realize that the tank was empty. They're just too thin, they're gonna burst right through it. You guys remember when I did that with Buddy, he broke the bag. These guys aren't so bad. One more. If you'll notice, I move really slow. I don't try to grab these guys quickly. They're gonna freak out if I do. I don't move quickly until the last moment, so I know I have them. So I think the move was entirely successful. This took less than what, like 8 minutes or something to move all 9 fish into their new home. If you can see, the wood in the back is giving the smaller ray a place of refuge until the other bigger guys get used to it. These fish look way bigger in this aquarium than in the 2000 though. So I mean, this is minutes into the aquarium. Everybody seems to be doing okay. No heavy breathing, nobody's too stressed out. Clearly nobody wants to be scooped up in a big net and moved. Arowana are fine as well. We got 1, 2, 3. Fourth one is over here. This was one of the reds. But yeah, this is absolutely 100% successful. Everybody's doing okay. As you can see, the little one's under the, so she's just right under there, minding her own business. This piece of wood's gonna do two things. One, give the smaller arowana a place of refuge, but also the bicher, who would probably enjoy hiding out a little bit as well. Now, gotta finish prepping the 2000. Once again, moving the fish was entirely successful. Huge shout out to Gary for being able to come over and move the fish. Wouldn't been able to do it without him. Well, I might have been able to do it without you. It would have went much more horribly. I can only imagine how nervous he was, not only moving stingrays, but these fish are, you know, worth thousands and thousands of dollars. I don't know, how do you think you did?
I didn't really worry about the money or anything like that. It's your fault if you asked me to help out. Actually, I volunteered to do it. I don't mind doing it. It's fun.
I volunteered. He didn't want to get stung, nobody does. But again, thanks to Gary. Huge shout out to him. If you guys aren't aware of it, Gary actually runs his own podcast now and he has a YouTube channel. Maybe someday I'll be on it. We probably won't talk about fish. He does a bunch of various things. If you guys want to see more of Gary, you can go on in the link in the description below, subscribe to his YouTube channel and see his podcast that he uploads, what, every week, once a week?
Yeah, probably about that. Try to anyway.
Awesome. All the sand has been pushed aside. Still draining a little bit of the water, using a small pump to do so. Have the back compartment removed. This is just right here. Moving along though. Okay, so we're now on to the next day. I wanted the fish to get a little more settled in before we did anything. The transfer went amazing. No damage to the arowana at all. All the rays are doing fine. Even the bicher has been out and about, seemingly loving his new tank, at least for the moment. I knew leaving the wood in there would give him a place of refuge. Black diamonds, little pearl. Look at the size difference. She's getting along just well. Being out and about with the rest means it's a good sign. She's out looking for food. I'm gonna feed them later on today though. Again, adding these guys in all at once, it was a rather large biological shock to the aquarium. I did do a water change, things cleared up. But ultimately, I don't wanna go too crazy, so I'll feed them later on today and monitor the water parameters, make sure everything's fine. But there's one last thing I gotta show you. I couldn't help myself. I had to start installing the background. The tank is completely drained and mostly dried. Now, the background isn't completely installed. To be honest with you, it's just kind of held in place with some clamps. Everything isn't even lined up. Nothing is glued. Nothing is, you know, it's not going to look like this. The roots need to be pushed back more and so forth. But I kind of wanted to give you guys an idea and go over a few points here. First and foremost, the background, once completely installed, for the most part, most of it, is going to be flat against the back of the tank, so it's not taking up any water volume that way. The roots look way bigger on camera than they are in person. One of the things we'll notice here is that now the entire aquarium is open swimming space, right? And so the rays are going to have all out front, but they can also swim under the roots as well. And of course, rays are not cemented to the floor. They can swim on top of the roots and explore and, you know, have a good time. I'm going to take you guys around to the other side here so you can get a better look of how this is potentially going to look. But I'm absolutely loving it. Now, being the, you know, a little bit of a math geek and, you know, loving to go over numbers and whatnot, I calculated how much space the roots come in contact with the base of the aquarium and how much space this background's taking up. And believe it or not, the previous background took up more floor space than this one. Again, this looks way bigger than it does. And that has more to do with the color of the background than anything. And you guys will know what I mean by, you know, if you paint a room white, it's gonna look a lot bigger than say if you paint it brown. Darker colors do tend to make spaces look smaller. I love it. AquaDecorBackgrounds.com did an absolutely stunning job. I can't believe they pulled off something so amazing. This is just one of the standing logs right there. I was just kind of trying it. If I do go with them, it's gonna be off to the sides here. I'm not gonna have them out in the open. I'm gonna leave this wide open for the rays and whatnot. But if I, you know, if we kind of come up like this, you can see now there's tons of space there. And we're not really taking up much space on the sides or anything like that. Absolutely phenomenal. I'm in love with it. I hope you guys like it, but I've got a long day ahead of me. This is gonna take a lot more time than I thought. I wanna line it up perfectly, and I want it in there nice and snug, so I have a few tricks I'm gonna do, but this is gonna take me a day or two. I even have some ideas on how to speed up the curing process by using less silicone and using different materials to secure it. And then of course, once I'm done, we can move on to the plumbing and filtration. Like I said, nothing's lined up here, look. So everything still has to be pushed back by several inches. And again, I just need an idea. I know you guys would have appreciated an idea, but I'd love to get your guys' thoughts and ideas on this so far. What do you think? Do you like it as much as I do? I think this is absolutely stunning. I love it. I can't wait to get some water in it and move the fish into it. And just see the arowanas gliding through the water, the rays covering the surface. Oh, it's gonna be awesome. Can't wait. I'll see you guys on Thursday.